A little over a year ago now, I made a video called What's in My Stack, and I've since opted for a simplified natural regimen. I think it's good to cycle on and off these things every few months to avoid building a tolerance. I'd like to take some time now to go over the three main components of my latest stack, for anyone who's interested, and sort of break down the reasons as to why I'm currently taking what I'm taking. Coffee. Why? I think the reason is obvious here. Caffeine. But coffee, unlike synthesized caffeine pills, comes from brewed beans that contain a whole list of other beneficial biocompounds. Also, whether served hot or cold, it's consumed in beverage form, which is typically consumed slowly, rather than hitting your body with 200 mg tablets, which I've found from personal experience to be not such an ideal way to utilize the performance-enhancing effects of caffeine. Another notable mention aside from coffee is Yerba Mate, which has a more well-rounded methylxanthine profile. Caffeine is a methylxanthine, by the way. I find that while coffee gives a stronger, more immediate boost, Yerba Mate's energy boost is less intense but more consistent, and typically doesn't result in a crash, at least from my experiences with it. Creatine. Why would I use that? Creatine is a naturally occurring amino acid found in a variety of foods such as fish, supermarket meats, and wild game. Creatine increases ATP within cells, not just muscle cells, but all cells within the body, including brain cells. ATP is the body's main energy source, so its energy boost is non-stimulant, unlike caffeine. It decreases fatigue by supplying more fuel to cells. In addition to getting brain cells extra fired up, creatine also has some nootropic properties of its own. A major bonus to creatine is that it's been shown to help ward off cognitive decline in old age by acting as a neuroprotectant, meaning it protects brain cells from damage. Specifically, creatine protects against excitotoxicity, which causes damage to nerve cells, potentially even killing them from excessive stimulation by certain neurotransmitters. Omega-3s. Why? Because your brain is the fattest organ in your body. After water, the human brain consists of at least 60% fat. That fat is not just any fat, by the way. We're talking about essential fatty acids here that are required for the maintenance and optimal health of your most important thinking organ. It's important to note that these fats cannot be synthesized by the body and must be obtained from dietary sources. Particularly, the omega-3 fatty acids are important for brain development. EFAs, essential fatty acids, determine our brain's integrity and performance. As science further unlocks the mystery of how fatty acids affect the brain, and better understands the brain's critical dependence on specific EFAs, correct intake of an appropriate diet or supplements become one of the tasks we must undertake in pursuit of optimal wellness. It's for this reason that I supplement with at least 3 grams of high-potency fish oil every day. Which brings me to another important role of omega-3s, and this is as an anti-inflammatory agent. A lot of cognitive decline is also related to inflammation. Also, the anti-inflammatory properties are not only limited to the brain, which is good all around. I tend to work out a lot, and I don't feel creakiness in my joints nearly as much when I'm taking fish oil as when I don't. What I like about this stack in particular is that supplementing with creatine and omega-3s and probably coffee to the least extent, or a caffeinated, some kind of natural caffeinated beverage, is that it's a stack that enhances the body holistically without focusing too much specifically on just brain power, because that approach is, I've found, to be too lopsided.